Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to talk about how to lock down a formula and what relative versus absolute references are in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here I have a standard spreadsheet in Microsoft Excel. I have sales from quarter one and quarter two. And over here in column C, I have a formula that is A2 plus B2. And if I use the autofill by double-clicking on this square on the bottom right of my cell, when I click into row 3, I can see the formula is changing to A3 plus B3. And then when I click on row 4, it's A4 plus B4. And row 5, it's A5 plus B5, etc. This is called a relative reference. And by default, Excel uses relative references all the time because it assumes that the user wants the formula to change with the row or column that the formula is being copied to. But what if over here I were to put some other fixed costs? So let's just type in fixed costs. And in this cell, let's just say those fixed costs are $500. Now, if I go over here and I want quarter one sales plus quarter two sales, and I edit my formula over here to include my fixed costs, and I hit enter, I can see that those are being added up correctly here. But if I autofill, I'm still getting the same numbers. And if I click on row 3, I can see that now this right here is pointing to I2. And I2 has no data in it. I really want that to point to I1 every time I am changing the formula.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So let's go back in C2. Now there are two different ways you can say that I want this cell to be added every time. I can go up here in I and I can put a dollar sign before the I, and then I can put a dollar sign before the one. And if I hit enter and let's do the autofill again, I can see that each one of these formulas are now pointing directly to I1 and it is not changing. That's because when I have the dollar signs up here, I no longer want a relative reference and I no longer want this to relatively be changing. I want what's known as the absolute reference. So let's take these dollar signs out and hit enter. And I just want to show you another shortcut. So I can manually type those dollar signs in, or I can go right before my cell and I can hit function F4, and you can see that the dollar signs are added in automatically. If I hit function F4 again, I can get a dollar sign in front of the one. If I hit function F4 again, I can get the dollar sign put in front of the I. If I hit function F4 again, I can remove them from everywhere. And if I hit it again, I can add them to everywhere. So there are a few different options that you have for adding in the dollar signs. So what are these other options? I just showed you with the dollar sign in front of the column and the dollar sign in front of the row. That means this cell will remain locked all the time. But sometimes there's a scenario where you want to be able to move the column as a relative reference, but not the row. So what if I put 500 here, 600 here, and 700 here? And what if I had another part in my spreadsheet where I wanted these to move, but I only wanted the column to change depending on its location, but not the row? So if I go equals this and hit enter, and I take that formula and I copy it across, I am getting my 500, 600, 700. But what if I highlight those and I copy them down? I'm getting the zeros because, again, I'm getting that relative reference. But if I go here and I do my function F4 and I hit enter and I copy that formula across, I'm going to only get 500 every time. So if I click over here, let's take off the dollar sign in front of the I and leave the dollar sign in front of the one. And I'm going to hit enter. And then I'm going to take this formula and copy it across. And now I can see that this is I, this is J, and this is K. And if I highlight those cells and I drag down, I can now see that the row is now staying locked as a one in each one of these cells because of the dollar sign that is before it. But the column, if you look up here, does keep changing. So I can do that same thing in the row format as well. So let's put 500, 600, 700, and then I'm going to delete these. So let's say I have this equal to I1, this is going to be equal to I2, and this is going to be equal to I3. Now, if I highlight these cells and drag them across, I can see I'm getting zeros again. But in this case, instead of locking the row, let's put the dollar sign in front of just the column. And now when I highlight these couple of cells and drag them across, I can see that the column is not changing, even though I am copying my data left to right. So you can lock the entire cell and use that to reference one cell. You can lock the column to just keep the column absolute and still change the row. And you can also lock the row and let the column be a relative reference. So hopefully that shows you three different options that you have for relative and absolute references within Microsoft Excel. If you would like more detail on how to do this, please visit our blog. I will include the link below in the description. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.